record a year for this year, 2019. Boxing writers had Rick Mirigian in there.
Well, Rick has done a really good job with Jose, with that deal. You know, he got him to fight
Maurice Hooker.
Maurice Hooker, and now the new contract they just signed, the purses that Jose's getting, that's a good manager. Look, sometimes see like trainers. There's been quite a few trainers that get trainer of the year with only one fighter, right?
It's true. And that fights twice a year.
Yes, that's enough. But if the fighter does good and beats good,
sometimes they're like big, like tough fights that he
beats
pulls
good
off.
Names and it looks upset. Impressive. Then yes, that's trainer of the year and that's fighter of the year because they did really good. Also, a manager does have to have 10 fighters to be manager of the year.
You're right.
You know, you could have 10 fighters. You could manage 10 fighters. But do you know the negotiations? Do you know the purses that he's negotiating for the fighter? No, just because he manages 3 or 4 world champions at one time, that doesn't mean he's the best manager. There could be one guy that does a really good job, and Rick Mirigian is one of them. I know his work. He calls me all the time. He explains to me everything that's going on. And he
does big moves, Robert. He sells out stadiums here and there.
He does big moves. You know.
And he's a very good negotiator.
Look, the show that they had in Stockton with Gabe Flores. Gabe Flores in Stockton. Gabe Flores is a name, but he's not a world champion. He's not a world class fighter. He's not a ranked, top ranked guy or anything. So the way Rick promoted that fight, I think they sold out. And it was just him, Flores, because the other fight, I think it was a world championship.
Andy Benson's would have done it first.
Yeah, but that probably sold out a lot of tickets too. But the main event wasn't, it was a world title fight, but it wasn't nobody popular. And then look, just recently in Fresno, this guy defended his title over there, Herring.
Yeah.
He made an event, the Marines.
And he's not from Fresno. The other guy's not from Fresno. The Marines broke. You know they broke the ring, Robert?
In Fresno, but they sold that. They packed the place
they
up.
They broke the ring. The Marines were jumping up and down, celebrating.
Remember they, the ring entrance?
Yeah.
That was all ring. That's a manager, man. Somebody that could do stuff like that.
Hey, Franco, for his fight, Robert?
He doesn't have world champions.
A bunch of turtles should walk him in. Humans dressed as turtles.
And he should walk alongside the turtles. It'll take him 2 hours to get there.
But I think he should do it. Do something. Do gimmicks. It works.
You know what I mean? Rick knows how to fucking manage. He knows how to promote, the events, And he did a great job in Henry's last fight over there. And there was nobody, no local fighter at all.
Not one
local fighter from Fresno. And I think he had a little over 7,000 people. That was impressive. That's a good manager, a good promoter, somebody that does stuff like that. I think Rick deserves it.
That's true.
What he's done with Jose, people don't even know all the things that he goes through with Jose. And he does it. He makes it. He gets it happening.